Tayo naman ngayon ay nasa week 4 na, lesson 1, na may pamagat, multiplication of decimals up to 2 decimal places by 1 to 2 digit whole numbers. Handa ka na ba? Mahalagang malaman nyo, in multiplication of decimals is somewhat similar to multiplication of whole numbers. For sure, you are familiar with the rules on how to multiply. After going through this lesson, you are expected to multiply decimals up to 2 decimal places by 1 to 2 digit whole numbers. Let us explore the process. Try to answer the given questions. Look at the square with one sides measuring 4 and 2/10 centimeters. Can you guess its perimeter? How can you find the perimeter? How many sides does the square have? What can you say about its sides? A square has 4 equal sides and each measures 4 and 2/10 centimeters. We can compute this as 4 times 4 and 2/10 equals n. Okay, arrange in column. Multiply like the whole numbers, regroup if necessary. So let us multiply. 2 times 4 equals 8, 4 times 4 equals 16. Count the number of decimal places in the factors. Sa first factor o ang multiplicand, ito ay 1 decimal place. At ang multiplier ay 0 decimal place. Then, place the decimal point in the product. The decimal place in the product is equal to the total number of decimal places in the factors. Kaya naman, ang product ay 1 decimal place, kaya ilalagay natin ang decimal point sa gitna ng 6 and 8. So, the perimeter is 16 and 8/10 centimeters. Physical activity burns calories. For every 3,600 calories burns in your body, you lose 1 pound. Look at the table below and compute the total calories burned while doing some related activities. Activities, calories per hour per pound. For jumping rope, 3 8/10. Walking, 2 4/10. House cleaning, 1 6/10, running, 2 5/10, and swimming, 3 8/10. Suppose you weigh 85 pounds and walk for 2 hours. How many calories did you burn? Solution, you need to multiply 85 times 2 hours and 2 4/10. For solution, 85 times 2, 5 times 2 equals 10, 2 times 8 plus 1 equals 17. Then, multiply 170 times 2 4/10. 4 times 0, 0, 4 times 7 equals 28, 4 times 1 plus 2 equals 6. Then 0 times 2 or 2 times 0, that is 0. 2 times 7 equals 14. 2 times 1 plus 1 equals 3. Let us add. Bring down 0. 8 plus 0 equals 8. 6 plus 4 equals 10. And 1 plus 3 equals 4. Ang 170 ay 0 decimal place. Ang 2 and 4 tenths ay 1 decimal place. Therefore, ang ating product ay 1 decimal place. Kaya ang decimal point ay mapupunta sa gitna ng 8 and 0. And that is 408. This means that you burned 408 calories during 2 hours. For learning task 1, solve the following problems. Write your answers in your notebook. Ating sagutan ang number 1. Weight, 102 pounds, 3 hours, and jumping rope. 102 times 3 equals 2 times 3 equals 6. 3 times 0 equals 3. 3 times 1 equals 3. Then, i-multiply itong 306 sa 3 and 8 tenths. Ito yung jumping rope. 8 times 6 equals 48. 8 times 0 plus 4 equals 4. 8 times 3 equals 24. 3 times 6 equals 18. 3 times 0 plus 1 equals 1. 3 times 3 equals 9. Then, let us add. Bring down 8. 4 plus 8 equals 12. 1 plus 4 plus 1 equals 6. 2 plus 9 equals 11. Para sa decimal point, ang multiplicand ay 0 decimal place. Ang multiplier ay 1 decimal place, kaya ang product ay 1 decimal place. So therefore, 1,162.8 calories ang sagot natin for number 1. Kayo naman ang sasagot sa 2, 3, and 4. At alam ko na kayang-kaya niyo yan. For learning task 2, find the product. Write your answers in your notebook. Sagutan natin ang bilang isa. 4 and 2900 times 12. Let's multiply. 2 times 9 equals 18. 2 times 2 plus 1 equals 5. 2 times 4 equals 8. 1 times 9 equals 9. 1 times 2 equals 2, and 1 times 4 equals 4. Let us add all partial products. Bring down 8. 5 plus 9 equals 14. 1 plus 8 plus 2 equals 11. And 1 plus 4 equals 5. Ang multiplicand ay 2 decimal places. Ang multiplier ay 0 decimal place, kaya ang ating product ay 2 decimal places. Bilang tayo ng dalawa mula sa kanan, papuntang kaliwa, 1, 2. So ang sagot ay 51 and 48 hundreds. Remember this. In multiplying decimals using 1 to 2 digit numbers, always remember that the answer should have the same number of decimal places in both numbers you are multiplying. For learning task 3, solve the given problems. Write your answer in your notebook. Here's the problem. For problem number 1, if a notebook costs 5 pesos and 25 centavos, How much is the cost of 6 notebooks? Let's multiply 5 pesos and 25 centavos times 6. Let's multiply 6 times 5 equals 30. 6 times 2 equals 12 plus 3 equals 15. 6 times 5 equals 30 plus 1 equals 31. In multiplicand, that is 2 decimal places at ang multiplier ay 0 decimal place. Therefore, ang ating product ay 2 decimal places. So, the answer is 31 pesos and 50 centavos. For number 2 problem, a working student earned 25 pesos and 50 centavos per hour. How much does he earn in 4 hours? If he worked 3 days a week, how much does he earn in a week? So sa problem na to, dalawa ang ating sasagutan. Earn in 4 hours and earn in a week. 25 pesos and 50 centavos times 4 hours. Let's multiply. 4 times 0 equals 0. 4 times 5 equals 20. 4 times 5 equals 20 plus 2 equals 22. And 4 times 2 equals 8 plus 2 equals 10. Ang multiplicand ay 2 decimal places, ang multiplier ay 0, kaya naman ang ating product ay 2 decimal places. So, 102 pesos earned in 4 hours. Paano naman malalaman kung magkano ang kinita sa isang linggo na 3 araw nagtrabaho? 102 pesos times 3. Bakit 3? Kasi 3 days a week lang siyang gumawa. So, let's multiply. 3 times 2 equals 6. 3 times 0 equals 0. 3 times 1 equals 3. Then, a fixed peso sign. Therefore, 306 pesos earned in a week. Kayo naman ang magsasagot sa 3, 4, 5. Maraming salamat sa pagsama nyo sa ating araling ito. Ating ibahagi ito sa iba upang tayo rin ay makatulong. Maraming salamat. Paalam.